we're back.
For a second time.
For a second time. And you're must be thinking that, huh, this is the first time you've done this episode 6.
Well, that's just not true.
That's just not true at all. We did the episode, and we went to edit it like a week later, and we're like, oh, there's no audio for just any of it. We had our audio because we record that on a second source.
But not the game audio.
No game audio. And this is kind of an important episode.
Well, they say third time's the charm. Let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Let's really hope. I don't have the time, just in general, for that. So we have a party to get to.
We do.
Listen, I know for a fact nothing's gonna happen at this party. Just clear. You can turn this off right now.
Oh, but maybe.
But maybe don't.
But maybe. Please stay. Oh, God.
Please stay. Oh, boy.
We're so
alone. We need our 11 views.
We're so alone. That's why we do this.
It's just to try and connect to the world through anime.
Any human connection at all will do.
Let's leave here.
Okay.
I honestly, it's been a week since we played this episode.
Yeah, okay, so another lesson we learned from this experience is maybe don't record all of the episodes ahead of
time. Don't record so far ahead.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it makes it actually kind of impossible to realize when you've messed up.
Okay.
Okay, what's Ibuki all about?
Well, we know what she's all about already. Well,
she's about the party.
Yeah.
Hey. Hey.
Huh?
Hey.
What?
What comes before part B?
I don't want it.
What comes before part B?
I don't want, no.
Just in a list. If you were to have part B, theoretically, what would come before it?
Part A. Okay, let's, why else would I be here? Anyway, what are you doing in a place like this?
It's just outside.
I'm doing a little exercise so I can enjoy all the yummy food we're gonna eat.
Listen, that sounds right.
I'm excited to eat Terra's cooking.
Has he cooked for us yet?
No.
Okay.
No, because the food that we already saw in the restaurant was not his.
That was already there.
Yeah.
All right.
If someone is the ultimate cook, it's gonna be delicious.
It's probably gonna be pretty good. Or all poison.
Ooh.
Like, it would be so easy for Terror just to kill everyone,
every
no witnesses.
Every person all at once, get him in one giant sweep.
Did you see a giant, there's like a star flare.
No.
That like happened right there, and I heard like a little sound effect.
A sound effect too.
I don't know if I just missed something. Like a little Easter egg.
The little footstep sounds.
Yeah, right? It's pleasant. A little nice time walk. It's the night time for a nice time.
It's about time for the party.
She has got some serious self-esteem issues.
I know.
I just want to kind of hug her and just be like, hey, you're all right.
Okay, Hajime?
He's so short.
He is so short.
He's so short. Look at this. That or this is incredibly on purpose. Anime designers, you nasty. Look at this. Am I crouching? Is there a button for crouching? Because Hajime appears to be about 3 foot tall.
He is at Nekumaru's crotch level. Do you remember that?
Yeah. When we just walked in, it was just like, oh, what's up, bulge? Which is also just now what I'm calling Nekumaru.
I let Fuyuhiko know about the party, but he didn't look too pleased about
it. He's the little gangster.
He doesn't look too pleased about anything.
Little gangster, also a pretty good name.
Lil Gangster.
Lil Gangster. That sounds like a doll that they would target to I don't know. I don't know who that's targeted to.
Let's go to the party.
My little gangster.
So this is the old building.
Compared to the hotel.
The old building. My arch nemesis.
I remember the door. You're here.
Whenever I look at someone, I want that sound effect to play. Like when I just look over at you.
Yeah. I felt it though. That was intense.
Right?
Yeah. Why do I have to do that?
Did you just hear him? He said, Hajime, stand up straight. He is crouching.
Yeah. Maybe Hajime's just got a real big slunch. That's a word, right?
That's why we're slunch? So short to everyone.
Body check. I didn't realize we were playing hockey.
it's necessary for me to take all possible security measures. Makes sense.
He is the island daddy.
Yeah.
He's trying to protect us. He vowed that he would, you know,
watching over all of us.
Not let a single person become a victim.
I get it.
Did you say he was washing over all of us? Hold up, let's not just gloss over that like you just said nothing.
I didn't. I said watching.
Oh, I heard washing, and I was like a beautiful wave? Or like, he's taking us into the bathtub.
The Akiya is just washing over
just
all of us.
Just scrubbing our bodies clean.
He is in this body check.
Yeah. He's just starting with his leg and working his way up.
I see.
Hey. Is he talking about our penis?
That's fine.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. He's his own bouncer to his party. Strange item.
Metal cases.
Metal cases.
Duralumin, actually.
Actually? This is a Duralumin? I found them at the supermarket. This one is used to store any dangerous items I found during body. What's the other one, dog?
The other one is for emergencies only.
It's a sex kit.
Oh, God.
What do you mean emergencies?
What do you mean, air quotes, emergencies?
Just sex emergencies. You know, how you have. Go and wait in the dining hall. Turned his back to
me. Look at his mouth open like that.
And that's the end of our talk.
I guess.
He is super cautious. Maybe that's so no one but him will have weapons.
Right? Then he has all the weapons now.
He has all the weapons. He can just murder us with these.
I don't know if we mentioned before, but after watching the anime, because we, or at least I didn't know anything about this game before we started this. Byakuya is just the Byakuya from the first game.
The exact same name, same outfit.
Same outfit, same personality.
But not everything is the same.
I'm actually pretty sure he has the same voice actor even.
Really?
And I think he even, like, all of his poses are the same.
Oh, wow.
But
there is one thing that's not quite the same.
Yeah. So I'm wondering, like, what is going on with him.
Yeah, right?
What does he know?
There wouldn't be another character from the first game because no one else is from the first game.
And that would make sense why he's being cautious, because, like, if he's the same person, which I don't know how much time has passed in game since the first one.
But also, like, the first person wasn't cautious at all.
Yeah.
He was just headstrong and was like, sure, try and murder me.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know, maybe it's not the same Byakuya, but, like,
this picture haunts me. I don't know why, but I find it super creepy.
It is.
Yeah, right? Just like the broken beach feels like where we are right now. Fire extinguisher.
Always good to have
just
on
open.
Hand.
Are we expecting a fire?
Byakuya is expecting everything.
And he's just gonna like light the building up while we're all inside.
Office.
Oh, no one's here. Oh!
Oh boy.
Someone's here.
I like the little like mouth covering that he's doing.
He's just so happy. Ow. He's snickering. He has to hide his joy. Alright, well. That is a high AC.
What can we see? What can we check?
Remote control for the air conditioner. I wonder if the filter is clean.
Hajime, always looking out.
Just, you know, Hajime has his HVAC repair diploma. Circuit breaker.
That's a circuit breaker.
That is super high up for a super breaker.
Leave here, yes. Very good, very good.
A super breaker is what you call me when I go to an all soup buffet. I'm gonna break that soup. This bathroom appears to be unisex. I don't need to go now. I should hurry over to the dining hall.
We haven't gone to the bathroom, though, yet since this game has started.
That's a really good point.
He has a super bladder.
Or a urinary tract infection. Probably that one.
That would mean you have to go all the time.
But you get it if you don't go.
Oh.
Yeah. tantalizing aroma wafting from the kitchen.
Ooh.
Nakamura, you're the only tantalizing aroma I want.
Sheesh.
Byakuya will yell at me if I don't go straight into the dining room. I like that even Nakamura is afraid of Byakuya. He's just like, oh man. Let's go check it out.
Kitchen!
Bet Teru will be in here.
I'm ready for that tantalizing aroma.
Ooh, look at that big old stack of meat.
Does he have an upside down F? Is that an F? What is that? Oh, that's a T for Teru, right?
How in the world is that a T for Teru?
I don't know. The bottom is like...
I don't know what that's supposed to be. It's probably... It doesn't even look like any... Oh, it is a T.
Yep.
Like, okay, that's a weird T. That is like a Flintstone stack of meat. It's just like the most... Like, where did he find those supplies on the island?
Okay, wait. Can we just like look at this meat for a second? Look at the size of Teru's just whole body. And
whole
the
body.
Size of that meat.
That's a human. Just proportion wise.
Look at the size of the meat compared to the size of like the pots and pans.
How did he cook it? He couldn't... Like, even the oven's not big enough for that.
Hello there.
Whoa. Whoa, that was a power-up sound effect. I've already prepared all the dishes. Look at his anime fingers. He's got,
funny little boop nose.
He does have a tiny little boop nose.
What does that even mean?
Teru. While I don't really appreciate him as a person because he's a huge pervert, his anime pose game is on point.
Oh, for sure.
Like 100%.
Also, his like voice actor when he laughs is like pretty good. Like,
yeah. He actually kind of sounds like he has the same voice actor as Monokuma. Like,
except for when he actually speaks.
Yeah.
Anytime he speaks.
Oh, hey Sonya, just. Hanging out in the corner?
Those are weird looking things. Those like...
What are those? Those are bolts.
But they're like enormous.
They're very large bolts.
Like wait, look at the bolts for a second. They're bolts attaching the panels.
Yeah. Okay.
Screws.
Well.
I see.
So this is what the inside looks like. This is what it's like on the inside.
There are so many gaps in the wooden floor.
All right.
I must tread carefully. My adventurous heart is pounding with excitement. I like Sonya. Sonya?
Storage room.
Old building. Storage room. Laundry, boxes, this jumbled mass of stuff all stacked together. I don't like how dusty it is in here. Hajime is really concerned about dust. First he wanted to know if the air condition, like, filter was clean.
I just want him to, like, be carrying around, like, a dustpan or, like, a feather duster and be like,
No, I like to think that he's really meticulous about it all. Like, he's just really particular, taking his time with it, thinking about the stars and the waves.
That's true.
Getting distracted by every little thing. Ultimate distraction student.
This is a laundry hamper. It looks like you can put dirty clothes in here.
Looks like it. You know, you can put dirty clothes anywhere. It's actually a trick that I've learned. I mostly put it on the floor. It's a lot of irons. I've got
These
a lot of
irons
in the fire.
Were they used to prepare the tablecloth?
If so, why do you need three? I should head over to the dining hall. It's weird that there's like still a camera right here.
Looking at like the corner of the room.
Just those
where
boxes.
Where the stack of boxes is.
Yeah. Maybe there's something behind the boxes.
Dining hall. Have we checked everything out?
I think so. Take a sip of my coffee.
Oh.
Hajime, how do you like it?
This is very nice. It has like those...
Oh, this is a...
paper chains swanky and
party.
Everywhere.
Yeah. This to me looks like a fancy party. Like a gala at a museum.
Yep.
You brought the carpet?
They have everything at the supermarket. Oh.
Sure does seem like it.
Hajime seems to agree with me.
I actually wanted to cover the whole floor, but I guess the carpet wasn't big enough. There's a lot of dust and cobwebs all over the place, too. Took me all day to clean the dining hall just because of that.
It would. I mean, this place is huge.
It's pretty large. But all day? No. There's no way I could handle being stuck cleaning the whole day. Hajime's just, like, gotta get out and see the world.
Well, Hajime's so impressed. You're commendable, Nagito. Cleaning up all of that dust.
Oh, man.
A boy after my own heart.
You sure did clean that dust. Did you check the air filters, though? Like, 1 second.
People always forget to check those air filters.
Nagito and Hajime have a little cleaning convention. Oh, everyone's here now. Or not everyone, but a lot of people.
Gross.
That creep Byakuya rubbed his ham hands all over me and called it a body check. More like sexual harassment. You know, I thought that too.
Yeah.
I thought he just kind of... Maybe Byakuya is just longing for human touch. Just like us. You know, Byakuya and us, I don't think we're all that different.
It's a body check, guys. Yeah.
It's... Now come in here. Come in here. Yeah, no, this hug is a body check. It's part of it. That's... Nope, hold it. Hold it. I need this. Getting frisky.
Yeah.
Are you pretty in demand, Hyoko?
Actually, she's so short, we might be her height. I was just thinking that.
That's true, actually. Like, we're all supposed to be the same age, but Hyoko and I are clearly
look
like...
Look how short she is compared to everyone else.
Let's see what soda's all about. We brought the soda to the party.
I feel
so
like,
uncomfortable.
Should we start calling him from his first name?
No.
Kazuichi?
Never. That man is soda. You know why? Because his personality's so bubbly.
How annoying.
Yelling at me when I noticed I had a wrench with me.
He is a mechanic.
It'd be kind of hard to kill someone with a wrench.
That's true. A wrench doesn't really
like,
offer very...
Like, it would take a while.
Like, you wouldn't be able to do... I mean, you could hit someone with it, but it's not like you could...
You're not hiding the fact.
Yeah.
Man.
Hajime just condemning him. Holding on to it keeps him calm is what that last slide said.
Aww.
Aww.
He's got anxiety too.
Yeah, it's like a teddy bear, but for a mechanic.
I like him.
Aw, man.
Soda's actually one of my favorites.
Did you just see that? You just said sniffle.
Aww. Also one of my favorites, Akane. Because look at that. That's just a good look. Hajime's just terrified.
Hey!
Like, Akane's looking at him. She's so hungry that she just sees, like, a cartoon depiction of a roast turkey.
That's so true. She's looking directly at us.
Yeah.
She's completely focused on the food.
Yeah, that's what we'll call it. That sweet meat. Even though that man is lowly worm. Man. Oh,
he's talking
skills.
About Taro Taro.
Listen. Okay.
Yeah, I agree.
Like, we're a little cruel to him, but that's just because he told Sonya.
He brought it on himself.
He really did. I guess we can try and forgive him, but... Worried about Monokuma showing up? That's a good point.
Yeah.
There are cameras in every one of these buildings. He knows that it's happening.
He totally knows. I mean, let's not think that he just doesn't have any idea.
Yeah, that there would be, like, no way. Like, and he just kind of appears. Where, oh. Have we seen her hoodie before? It's got little cat ears.
Yeah, it's cute.
It's cute.
I would wear that.
Yeah.
I like her too. She's got a very calm,
so chill.
Yeah.
I think she knows she's in a video game.
Oh, she
has
to
know. Is my theory. Yeah. Mahiru is a little too intense for me.
She is, but I can tell she's got some, like, weird insecurities.
Yeah, well, she's got a good heart. Like, she seems nice enough, but she's just, like...
They're talking about how there are spaces in the wooden...
Floorboards
again.
Carpet is spread out enough to cover most of the floor, so I guess it won't be that big of a deal.
They must, like... Those must be pretty big gaps for everyone to bring it up.
Yeah, everyone's like, man, I hope we don't fall into the ground.
Those floorboards, though.
She is the type to trip over nothing.
Is she? Mikan, I feel like that's, what's her face?
The no, nurse. Mikan, that's Mikan, the one yeah. that she's talking about.
Oh, I thought she was talking about herself.
Yeah. Yeah, she's saying that the nurse will definitely hurt herself. There are lots of fancy-looking party dishes on the tables toward the front.
Oh, that food looks good, though.
Wait, what about... There's just, like, this table in the back.
There are two tables in the back. Such a big table.
Such a big table. Hajime, always concerned about the measurements of things.
Yeah.
We talked about this in later episodes. He's constantly wondering about the general size.
We talked about them in earlier episodes, too.
Okay, yeah, he's concerned. About length.
So see that bottle, the bottle of soda in the back looks like blood because...
Oh, because it's... Yeah, because it's
like
pink.
Teru Teru bleeds pink from his nose.
Yeah. Iron plates? Metal gear? That reminds me. I saw some similar iron plates in the hallway too. Yeah, there were. That's ominous. All is not what it appears to be.
He's got a lightning bolt across his eye.
Has seen what lies shrouded amidst the darkness? What? I never know what this guy is saying.
Though the iron plate appears to be bolted to the wall, it's actually bolted over what's known as a window.
Some people might know the concept of a window. Have you heard of it?
I have not.
Oh, it's like a thing where... So there's a wall... But then there's just like a hole in that wall.
That sounds dangerous.
Yeah, no, I don't know why anyone
has
them.
Could people fall through this
hole? Absolutely.
Whoa.
Or sometimes most people just like look through them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Let me tell
you. Window? See, Hajime hasn't heard of them either. You're not alone.
Okay.
There are no windows in this dining hall at all, so you don't have to worry. Why are there iron plates covering these so-called windows?
The night is my domain.
If I'm remembering correctly, in the first game, there are iron plates covering all kinds of places.
That's true. All kinds of places.
Let's make history.
Such a fine day. Countless lives gasp their first breath. Countless more go the way of all flesh. Man.
I guess he doesn't know.
Gundam, I wish I could speak like Gundam does. Not regularly, but just sometimes. Hajime just wrote the iron bolts off as renovations in place.
Wait, okay, we heard the voice of the ultimate affluent protagonist? When did he become the protagonist?
He was supposed to be the ultimate affluent prodigy.
He is.
Is that a translation error, or like, what's up?
No, he's just become... The protagonist.
Okay, he's become the main character.
We are now a side
character. I'm glad that we're just a side character. That's way less pressure on us.
Fuyuhiko did not come.
I apologize.
Did anyone really expect him to?
Jeez.
Mandatory party. You'll have fun and you'll like it.
Pose a problem.
He won't be able to do anything. I guess that's true if one person's outside the building.
Yeah, then you know, everyone knows that one, where they are.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, you don't know where they are, but you know they're not here.
And they can't get, like, they can't kill anyone if they're just out by themselves.
If they're, like, totally alone. If it were two people alone, that would be concerning.
Things might go down.
What? Come on.
What is that?
What is what? Well, what?
Various food dishes on it.
Not possible.
Dangerous.
Is that his stomping noises?
Yes, it was. Oh, okay.
Hey, what are you doing? You're hogging all the food. Not fair.
No, I'm not.
I don't care what you say. You're totally picking
out. I like
out.
That.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, I'm not. Look carefully at this dish.
I'm not picking out.
It looks like delicious roasted meat.
And just what
is he testing it for poison?
He's like my dad testing all the foods for poison.
Or like when your parent on Halloween is like, I gotta take some taxes.
Yep.
They try and teach you about business with candy.
It's an iron skewer.
I guess you could do some damage with that.
Iron skewer is definitely a dangerous item. I must take full responsibility and collect it.
Well, you know, you could have just slid the meat off of it.
Nope, Island Daddy to the rescue.
He is the Island Daddy.
Hello?
I've already said that, like, three times.
I know, but, like, it's really dawning on me. With everything he does.
Yeah, everything he does is very daddy. Oh, man. Terror is gonna be out for blood.
Are you a food critic? He looks so worried now.
Yeah.
What are you thinking?
I mean, listen.
What are you plotting?
Byakuya looks like he could be a food critic.
Oh.
I'm sorry. No, that was very rude. That churrasco is a South American meal where you stab meat on an iron. Dude, that's just a kebab.
Yeah.
You're just describing a kebab. Totally fit the party's atmosphere.
Why?
There might be more skewers than just these.
Let's go.
Why us?
Whenever it makes the stomping sound effects, I picture him as that one heartless in Kingdom Hearts that, like, runs.
Yeah, the one who, like, kind of does the waddle run.
It's, my condolences. Well, I guess we are his, like, I'd say we're Byakuya's closest friend.
He, like, seems to trust us the most. I think he knows that we're not trying to kill anyone.
I reluctantly followed him.
Reluctantly crouched at the starting line. Engines thumping and bumping in time. We have to thoroughly inspect it to make... He's just gonna eat all the food, isn't he?
Thoroughly, huh?
Thoroughly. Stomped into the kitchen.
He's on a mission to protect us all.
Yeah, listen, it's commendable. Alright, let's search this place thoroughly. The whole kitchen. Really, not even fork? Like, knives, I get. Difficult to kill someone with a fork.
What are you gonna do with a fork?
I mean, my dad once threw a fork into his brother's neck.
Oh, don't. Blah.
That's a thing that happened in their
teen
years.
See, Hajime is saying, don't tell me.
Naturally.
Hajime doesn't want to know.
If it's...
Chopsticks are enough? Like, I guess. But, listen. Did you see how big that meat was? Chopsticks aren't gonna do the trick.
We're all just gonna eat it with our hands.
Alright. Like, but if you are going that far, you can kill someone with your hands.
Yeah, anyone could strangle anyone else.
Yeah. Chinese, Japanese, French, and Italian cuisine. Seafood dishes, too. Meat on the bone.
That Teru, he sure got fired up.
I don't even know if I'll be able to... Well, you probably couldn't alone, dude. Shouldn't try. Like the skewer in the Trasco. Fish bones and meat bones were also dangerous items.
It's an equipment list.
Shows everything that should be in the 5 iron skewers, 3 frying pans. Listen, you could do some damage with a frying pan.
Yeah.
Also, iron plates for barbecue, and even a portable stove for cooking hot pots.
Iron plates and a portable stove. I do recall...
Should be no problem using it. Apparently... Hajime knows a lot about the standards of modern restaurant kitchens. One of the items on the list seems to be short by one. Do we have to just keep looking? Is it the knives? They seem to be all there.
What?
Out of the question. Well, yeah, I would say knives are the most dangerous.
Yeah, listen, we can get behind on, like, maybe knives shouldn't be around.
All right.
Byakuya is the ultimate weapon.
His whole body is a weapon.
Don't make me repeat
You know,
myself.
Like when you take martial arts and you convert your body into like a...
Look at him. He's the epitome of just weaponized man. Because it's necessary. Not to let anyone become a victim.
What?
What do you mean? I'm just assuming I think something must have happened to you? Hey man, I think you must have had a messed up childhood. That's a weird thing to say to someone, Hajime. After all, you decided to throw a party so suddenly. I can't help but think there's a reason for that. Like, yeah, because so we can't murder each other.
If you put everyone in one spot, you can watch everyone.
Exactly. That just makes sense.
He's had trust issues for as long as he can remember.
Join the club. I don't really like to talk about my past. Oh, like how you were in this murder school trip once before? I'll tell you just a little bit of it. Okay. Cannot talk to others about my past. I suspect that my skeptical nature is partly to blame. Why is he so skeptical?
Also, that's a hard word to say. Distrusting others and being distrusted in return. For a long time, my life has been a living hell.
Whoa, dramatic.
It was inevitable that I would end up this way.
Well, he's the ultimate affluent prodigy, right?
Yeah.
Like, I guess if you're the heir to a huge business, like, people are probably out to get you.
Yeah.
That kind of makes sense.
My skeptical nature might be of good use this time around. If we are to survive here, skepticism is necessary at all costs. That makes sense.
That is, like, listen, that's actually probably my attitude that I would take to it. Everyone else seems to be like, no, we won't murder. Let's just trust each other.
But in all reality, like, there's a lot of people here and you don't know any of them, you know?
One of them is straight up a Yakuza boss.
Yeah.
Like, he's almost definitely murdered before. That past you mentioned.
That's enough.
Okay.
There will definitely
be a time.
If nothing happens and time passes for us peacefully, I will have no choice but to talk. Weird.
Have no choice?
That sounded pretty deep, Yakia.
Whoa, heavy, man. I'm sort of feeling feelings.
This guy might have a deep mystery hidden within him deeper than I thought he'd have.
Listen, I just like to dust things and look at the general measurements of palm trees. I don't really deal with feelings.
Such silly talk.
Enough silly talk. That's a nice dialogue line.
Even so, he sure works his heart. That's probably more in line with his actual personality, I bet.
Hey, Tower Terror. What's up?
He just pops out of nowhere.
Stop talking.
Don't raise your annoying voice. Man, tensions are high. This is why we need the party.
Yeah.
People need to drink and unwind. Let's let loose. Okay, pop quiz. Which character so far would you most like to party with?
Soda.
Oh, see, you chose the wrong answer. Correct answer is obviously Nekomaru. Nekomaru knows how to party.
You
literally
right.
Just said that.
No.
Arrange the plates.
Hajime!
Do you see that little graphic? Like the words Teru Teru just surrounded him.
Really?
Yeah, it was weird. Or maybe I'm just saying things. Like I saw the star earlier.
Yeah, maybe.
I might just be losing my mind.
Trust me, I'm the one who's depressed here.
Hajime! Rough, buddy. Before you start getting all flirty. Oh, that's right. As far as I know, that's been missing from the start.
No matter how clean this place gets, stuff is still bound to go missing in an old building, right?
Seems a little suspicious.
If it's been missing all along, we really can't do anything about it.
No place to hide such a long skewer anyway. They were long skewers.
Yeah.
I mean, Hajime. Of course he is.
Let's go.
Did you not think that after all of this, he wouldn't be paying attention?
He'd be like, okay, well, I did my job. Let's get wasted.
Well, his back is turned right now.
We're on a murder island. Hajime is not taking this situation seriously enough. They're finally back.
Hey.
What issue?
Lies.
I'll
Listen, Akane is ready to just throw down on a moment's notice. Safeguard this Deruleum case.
I know. Put it right in the middle of the room so everyone can keep a watchful eye on it.
That's a good call.
Yeah, see?
Yeah.
The safest place is in front of everyone.
Is in front of everyone because it's locked and no one can get there. Let's definitely not move it anywhere.
If you just put it in front of everyone and say, okay, no one touched this, then nothing's gonna happen.
Or just put it on that empty table in the back.
Yeah.
I see.
Yeah, well...
Then...
Don't just, like, leave someone out there. That's the person that gets murdered.
Splitting up always leads to murder. Everyone knows that.
It's a classic scenario of split up murder.
I don't mind.
I really like wondering what it was like in the recording studio. Be like, just record some sounds.
That's good. We'll take a few more takes. Wrote a song about this. Title would definitely be Lonely Girl in the Storage Room. I'm not sure Ibuki's such a great musician. It's not a really good title.
Yeah, we don't want her to sit alone while a party is happening. That's
also because she's got like the most proficiency with all the weapons.
Wait a minute, how did she bring that giant thing in here?
You know how she did that Boken, the wooden sword on her back? You know how she did it? The artist didn't want to do another drawing. That's how she got it in.
Okay.
But that's actually a really good point. She could totally just kill someone.
I mean,
with that.
If Kazuichi Soda had to get rid of his
wrench. And she's master swordsman.
Yeah.
That's her skill.
But
might be better if you avoid the storage room. Eh?
Why is that? Packed with lots of stuff, it's hard to see in there and full of cobwebs.
Huh.
Okay. I mean, listen, it's a big room. I think it would be bad. I think maybe Japan is really worried about just dust in general. I stayed in some dusty places. I'm fine.
In that case, why don't you guard it in the office? Well, that is at least close.
Yeah, it is. Circuit breaker, too. That's true. We wouldn't want the lights to go out.
Yep.
The office sounds nice. I'm pretty sure it's not that dirty, so we're all good.
Thanks, Nagato. Always looking out.
Understood.
Have fun tonight, everyone. I'll just go play with my sword.
By myself.
Man. She seems like maybe the kind of person who wouldn't want to go to a party anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I see.
It's true.
She does have a super cool melancholy vibe.
Huh?
100%. The other case, that's... Yeah, what's...
Oh, that's his special case
it's
he won't
sex
tell
kit.
Us about.
You mispronounced sex kit.
That's weird.
That's true.
Gakia yeah, I've been saying that all along. When you're special as me, you get special privileges.
The daddy privileges. It's hard to argue with you.
Listen.
Stay with me at all times. Take full responsibility for watching over
well,
it.
Well, if he has it with him, you know.
Like, if it's in his arms, but like... Oh.
Stop talking.
Still more?
Just stop talking.
Man, this is a boring party. She keeps on wanting to fight.
Nuisance. What nuisance?
That's right.
Monokuma.
Oh. Well, he... I mean, if he wanted to, he could do
he
anything.
He would already be here.
Yeah.
I'll show you my serious side.
Whoa.
That's actually a really cool drawing.
Hold on.
They both have spiky shoulders.
Move.
It's because of all their energy.
Hey.
Ponin is not something we can just fight. That's true. If you touch him, you just get killed.
Hey.
Okay? Chiaki
I'll
wants...
do something about it.
there's the two people who are like super buff and constantly want to fight, and then Chiaki's just like,
hey guys, I got it.
What?
Even Byaki doesn't believe it. Look at that face.
Hey, hey.
Aw.
Hey, man. Listen, girls can do just as much as anything. You heard me. Nope. Just as much as anything.
It's not like I'll personally do something.
Okay. What?
Monami.
Yep. Monami.
But I can talk her into helping us.
She does seem to be on our side, but
I wonder
like,
what she does in her spare time.
Spare time? What do you think Monami's like living room looks like?
Which reminds me, we should check our pet.
Oh, that's a good point. Oh. Monami. Do they? I cannot tell what their relationship is, Monami and Monokuma.
It's like a forced brother-sister thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm about to sneeze.
Sneeze to the side. We'll cut it out.
Nope, I'm not going to.
Okay.
Yep. Well.
Are you okay?
Still think it's dangerous.
Everything is dangerous. We're on a murder island.
We are on a murder. To be fair, the island's not trying to murder us.
Yeah.
But
do we know that for sure?
No, we don't. Good point. Listen, in the wild, everything's trying to kill you. That's just life. I feel somewhat uneasy, almost as if I'm on a murder island. Something feels off.
Almost as if I'm on a murder island.
God, okay, yeah, can we party? Can we eat? There's, oh, thank goodness. That is how I feel right now. Exactly like that.
Fine.
Aw. His
banquet
hamsters have already started.
Yeah, they've begun to chow down.
I love how they just like look so happy.
They are thrilled. They are stoked.
And with that, the party started.
The party started. Let's get this party started.
Now that I think about it, I still don't understand why we're even having a party in the first place.
I ate so much I farted. Let's get this party started.
Last time we were all partying in the ocean, something bad happened. Whenever something good happens, something bad happens.
What are you talking about? That makes no sense. But whatever the reason, everyone seems to be having fun. They do seem like they're having a good time.
Yeah.
Hey, are we good? Can I finally eat?
You're already going.
You're already eating.
Soda gets it. Oh.
I can't stop.
I've been there. Oh.
I can't stop my
that laugh clip again. Jeez.
She's a little scary.
These are the world's tastiest party dishes after all.
Terror Terror is going to feed us so much we die. We all die of bloating and food babies.
You can't help but continue eating such exquisite delicacies.
Yeah, that sounds like our stomach's gonna rupture.
That is what
it's the
I
weirdest murder ever.
Tastiest dishes.
That's rather scary.
You're not eating? Then I'm gonna eat all this by myself. Come.
I'll make lots more in the kitchen, and then I'll bring it all out here, okay?
Yeah,
okay, wait, there's already so much food.
Look at those burgers, though.
Oh, yeah.
Down, like, in front, we should get some burgers. Mm-hmm. And that chicken or turkey, maybe? There's at least two turkeys.
Hey, everyone.
Other generic meat
it, why don't
slabs.
I take pictures for you guys? Wow, that sounds wonderful. Please do.
She is ultimate photographer.
Yeah. Is this the photograph, maybe? I don't know.
One of the photographs.
This feels weird. Watching everyone have fun was so frustrating. Now it feels reassuring.
Why would fun be frustrating?
Well, if you're not having fun because you're, like, worried about things,
yeah.
Like, I can understand it, but, yeah, I think maybe Hajime just has some emotional development.
We're actually, air quotes, friends.
Who fight together. Friends who've developed a sense of community, of unity. I can read. I know what's happening. Nekomaru needs to go to the bathroom. Just like always. Party's just started, but I must return to my cottage.
Come on.
Such selfish actions as just leaving.
Don't
as going back
me.
To my cottage.
Knows he's gotta go. Shame me as a man. He would poop himself. He would poop himself right here in the crowd.
Shame me as a man.
Wait, should I?
Yeah.
Okay. Shitting my pants would totally shame me as a man!
Pretty good.
Cool. When I do that raise at the end, and also our neighbors are probably very concerned about me right now.
Just shouting out that line.
Yeah. I mean, they would probably agree.
What?
You're contacting the inner Byakuya inside of you when you do that voice.
You mean Nekomaru?
That's what I meant. I'm looking at Byakuya.
I'm always looking at Byakuya. I need to get in touch with my inner island daddy.
What?
What is this blasphemy?
Impossible!
My hellhound earring has disappeared.
Did it vanish into subspace?
Probably not! If I had to guess, probably not. That's a fair point. It's probably down the slats, those big holes in the ground.
Shit.
I'm gonna shit! That really hurts. I should stop doing that.
You should also move away from the mic when you do that.
Or get way closer. I mean, you're already doing it.
Come on! Say cheese!
Cheese! Oh, not us.
Beep beep.
What?
Beep beep.
Oh, if he doesn't, that's not. Oh! It's dark? All of a sudden?
It's a blackout!
Oh god, I don't recognize their voices well enough for this.
Hey, I can't see anything!
Who's
Soda?
Soda.
As we
stumbling around the darkness.
God, that would be terrifying.
My future is pitch black!
That might be Akane?
Akane or Ibuki? One of the two. Frantic footsteps rang throughout the...
I think that was Ibuki.
We were immediately swallowed up by another sound. What?
Everyone, calm down. We gotta stay calm in a situation like this.
Sonia?
I think that's, either Sonia or what's her name, the one with the camera?
Mahiru.
Maybe.
Ah, don't step on my feet!
That's Hyoko.
What the hell? What's going on here?
Byakuya.
Oh, that would be terrifying.
That would be very scary. Complete darkness. Therefore, no matter how long I wait, there's no way for my eyes will adjust.
This is...
Ow!
Turn the damn lights on! I can't.
Somebody just said,
this,
ow.
You know?
That's Akane who said that. Who said the lights.
Yeah.
Guys? Where are you? Wasn't the blackout just in the kitchen?
That's Teru Teru.
Yeah, for sure. Because he was in the kitchen.
The breaker overloaded?
Hold on a sec.
That was Sonia.
I'll go along the wall and
Soda.
Do something about it.
I think so. This is, yeah.
Within the darkness, we fervently waited to be released from our fear. We anxiously waited, and after a while, it finally... Okay, Nekomaru's safe.
That's all you care about?
Yes. Nekomaru, Akane, wait, where's Soda?
Oh no.
Where's Soda? A shocking scene unfolded in front of our eyes.
Soda!
Where's Soda? Where's Soda? Mikan's appearance appears to be... Oh, boy.
Just click through this.
You just tripped again?
Seriously? How do you trip in?
Let's just click through this.
Okay, yeah, this is for no one.
Yeah.
This is not... Come... Okay, this is for, like...
I can't take this at all!
This is apparently for Ibuki.
It's time to snatch some shots!
Come on.
There's no
Ibuki's
way
the new Teru Teru.
Please forgive me. Just forgive me.
Oh, boy.
Everyone, I think it would be best if we help her already.
Yes! God. Mikan. I feel so bad for that girl.
I'm sorry.
Hey. Oh, boy.
How are you just tripping all the time?
That's a good question.
Oh, Soda. Oh, thank God. I'm going to keep him safe during this whole adventure.
How do you plan on doing that in this narratively driven story game?
I'm just going to watch over him.
Okay.
Remember when we hung out with him and he was talking about how all he wanted was friends?
Yeah, and how like his family was poor and like he never really got a chance to go to school.
Aw, and he's such a nice guy.
Soda's the best. You were unusually useful this time, Soda.
Hey.
Oh, never mind.
Guess not.
Just take it back. Why are the lights back on?
What? Are you stupid?
Oh.
Everyone's kind of mean to him.
I know. But like, look at him. He's the best. He looks like an X-Men.
Oh my.
What happened?
Yaki is missing. Oh. Snap, where's the island, daddy? Immediately looked over the dining hall.
Sure enough.
Nowhere to be. That's not great. Did he run off somewhere during the blackout?
Hey.
I'll look in the storage room. Can you check the entrance? Sure.
For now.
Go look in the office. Okay.
Look in the hallway. Well, listen, Akane. There might be something better to do with your time right now.
There's a time and a place for everything.
This is the time and the place to chow down.
I must bathroom. He's like losing all thought. Like,
yeah, he's like returning
cognitive
to
cognitive abilities.
Yeah, returning to just primal instinct. I must bathroom.
Sure.
I must man up and check the bathroom.
Jeez.
Is there an itty bitty blackout? Finger flick him. Go check the entrance.
Chiaki,
oh yeah, let's go
there.
See what's up with Chiaki. Is the bathroom still locked?
Damn it.
Oh man.
Someone else is using it.
It's been shut before the party even started? Bathroom is for everyone! You think maybe whoever caused the blackout was in the bathroom?
Wait, okay, so the bathroom was in use before the party started, but yeah. Everyone was present, right, in that room?
Yeah. So who could have used the bathroom?
Okay, wait. Yeah, okay. Let's just go check outside, I guess.
Yeah. Can't be Byakuya. Yeah. Alright, should we check in here? Oh no, somebody's checking the office already. No sign of Byakuya. Go see what's up with Chiaki.
This eerie music.
Seriously.
Huh? Oh, she doesn't even know that the blackout happened.
She doesn't
happened,
even know the
right?
blackout happened, yeah. Ooh. Haven't even joined in yet.
Nope.
But he didn't leave outside.
Yeah, which means that he's still in the building somewhere. Nobody came out.
I think.
I don't understand where they're keeping watch from on Akuma.
Yeah, right?
He could probably teleport in here if he wanted to.
Yeah, he could probably just, like, come up from the floorboards.
That's...
Wasn't in the kitchen.
No one was in the office. Is he in the bathroom?
He doesn't seem like the type of the... No, because the bathroom was closed before the party even started.
Right.
That's weird.
He doesn't seem like the kind of person who would...
Hey.
Not even Pekka was
oh,
there?
Oh, wait, no, because we heard him during the blackout. Oh, come on.
Well done.
It smells.
Uh-oh.
Well.
Do you think that maybe Nakamaru just farted? Yeah. Smells like shit.
Yes. Thanks, Mikan, for that science lesson.
Those are the mechanics of farting. Farting isn't something to be embarrassed about. I try telling you that all the time, and yet you still shame me.
Cause it
not like that.
Just cause I'm loud and proud.
Wait.
Smells like,
blood. Oh no.
Uh oh. That's not. Should we just
go over there?
I think we should just go over there.
The smell of blood.
What in the world is at that table?
Yeah, a little bit of fear.
I'm definitely nervous.
Oh, with a shot, I grabbed the...
Flipped it back in one go.
Oh,
Island Daddy! Those night vision goggles?
Our daddy! For the rest of my life, I will never forget what I saw.
Man, you and me both.
Yakuya was just trying to protect everyone.
Oh, man.
And beyond recognition.
What? He's very recognizable. Beyond recognition.
He's the only one who's wearing an entirely white suit.
And also, like...
blonde hair.
Yeah.
After one, destination despair.
Wait. That... Are we just now in chapter one?
Were we in chapter zero before?
I have no idea.
Why is Byakuya... No!
Our sweet, poor island daddy. Body of my... He can still be your friend.
Why?
You could just weaken to Bernie's him.
What is this?
Oh...
Hey! Are you kidding me?
Must have been some kind of mistake. Are we like jam or sauce? Is all liquid in this universe pink?
What the hell?
Well, Monokuma got in anyway.
Great job, Chiaki and Izumi. Not Izumi.
Monomi.
Yoo-hoo! Thrills, chills, kills!
Tropical paradise known as Jabberwock Island, the very first murder has finally taken place. It has taken us a significant chunk of 6 episodes to get to the first murder.
Oh yeah.
That's a while.
Could it be?
Does this mean... Poo hoo hoo.
That's right!
By one of you.
Like of in course. This room or just in general? Such a horrible expression on his face, don't you think?
Well, I'm glad we can't see it.
A face filled with... Yeah, wait. You cannot tell his expression at all. Maybe you could in the, Japanese version. Maybe it got censored.
Maybe.
Yeah. This isn't murder? What? Most likely sacrificed.
No, wait, I think we can see pretty
well,
clearly.
Well, it definitely wasn't a suicide.
True.
Thick, muddy feeling of despair swelled within my body. Ultimate description student is on the case.
What is this?
Acceptance is the first stage.
Pekka, where were you?
Why?
You were supposed to be guarding the circuit breaker.
The weapons, too.
And the weapons. And there's a knife right there.
What are you gonna do?
Do this the usual way? You know it's bad news because it's a ding-dong-dong-ding.
Yeah.
Howdy.
A body has been discovered!
Howdy. He must have recorded these ahead of time.
He did not get there that fast and also make himself a cocktail in that time.
Now then, after a certain amount of time has passed, the class trial will begin!
Our first trial. That we have already recorded.
Hey,
One of you gets murdered. The rest of you will have to debate about who you think is the blackened. Really weird term for just murderer.
Yeah.
Correct!
You must investigate and cover the blackened culprit. I like investigation things.
Yeah, like, I really like mysteries and detective stuff. Like, that's why we're playing this game in the first place. It's because you and I both really enjoy, like, detective stories.
Yeah.
If you make an outburst like that, you'll end up being a suspect.
Everyone's a suspect.
Yeah, seriously. We're a suspect.
We could have done it.
We didn't see what was happening.
We have memory loss, apparently.
No,
we can't remember our talent.
Maybe we just blacked out and stabbed him.
We're already being conned by the killer.
Oh. An impassioned, life-risking battle between you guys and the murderer. I'm just gonna say murderer. So that's what they are.
Hey!
What are you saying? Only ever one truth? Oh, there's multiple truths.
You have a grandpa?
I was just gonna say, he has a grandfather?
On my grandfather's
grave?
On my grandfather's
grandfather had a plane.
Emergency!
I really like that they just recorded the on my grandfather's line and didn't bother with any of the rest of it.
What happened to your grandpa? Did his plane crash?
Just him, like, okay, so this is the recording booth. We just need you to say on my grandfather's.
And then we'll fill in the rest.
We'll take care of the rest in post. Don't worry about it.
But act like you're about to say another word and we'll just like cut it off.
Yeah. Listen, we don't have the budget for the fourth word. We just really need to pare it down.
You ain't my comedy partner anymore.
He's filled with punches.
It hurts so much when you hit me with a charging corkscrew attack.
I don't understand these little vignettes. In the slightest. I don't understand the point of them. This game is weird, man.
Oh my god, she's filled with blood.
Yeah.
Can she bleed?
She clearly
Apparently
can.
Apparently she can.
Fine,
Unless
fine.
That's juice. Or jam.
Of and lovey doubt and dovey deception.
What? Put your heart and soul. Why were those highlighted?
And with that, Monokuma vanished, leaving those of us who were grief-stricken alone with our despair.
I thought we were supposed to say goodbye to despair.
That's the whole title of this game.
What is this?
She looks very upset.
She looks less upset.
Yeah.
What's going on?
He looks very confused and upset. Though that's maybe a weird way to phrase it.
Understand?
Can't doubt each other. Yeah, one of us was murdered.
Yeah, that's true. If we don't figure it out, everyone goes. We have to figure something out.
Yeah, because otherwise we all die except for the murderer.
This is survival at this point, yeah.
Yeah, for once I agree with Hyoko.
Shut up! Shut up!
Oh, everyone's tensions are high.
Yeah. Threats are scary! I just imagine a little, like, stuffed animal rabbit running away just shouting, threats are scary.
But...
like, waddling away.
Threats are scary!
No!
However...
Listen, everything is scary right now. There's no way. Except there is a way it happened. We're going to go investigate the way that it happened.
The blood is everywhere.
He's literally right back there, in that corner.
We can see his hand, his head, and some night vision goggles.
Yeah, that's what those are, right? Or binoculars?
Okay.
But why would there be binoculars?
Nagito, you can't prove that there's no killer. Clearly it happened.
Clearly there's a killer.
He did not fall on his knife, I assume?
Yeah, right?
Unless he was like...
Chasing someone
with a knife and tripped.
What if all of the murders in this game are actually just accidents, like caused by the person themselves?
That would be tragic, though. He goes to like
stop a murderer
because he was so worried about someone getting killed.
That sounds just like our island daddy.
Aww.
There's no mistake.
This despair.
The hopeless reality is the real enemy.
Oh man,
but
that's
the
reality I wake up in every day.
Did the hopeless reality do the murder?
What is life but one long murder? Can you?
Well?
Closed circle detective games, the player usually has to decide on who's going to guard the crime scene.
She knows she's in a game.
She definitely does! Closed circle crime games. Oh, like this one? That's an audio clip. I just would have loved being in the recording session for this.
I know. Is he okay?
It's bathroom time.
Man.
Soda recognizes a sensitive heart when he sees one.
You know, Nekomaru, sensitive heart, sensitive butt. I wanted to say that on my gravestone.
I'll just stay by Bakia's side.
Okay, so she's just gonna guard it.
So no one tampers with the crime scene?
Yeah.
Unless she tampers with the crime scene.
Oh, man.
She's just gonna... Yeah, she has medical training.
Right, she's a nurse. Perform the autopsy.
I mean, it's pretty obvious we're all just high schoolers.
Yeah, we're all just high school students who are being forced to murder each other. Yeah, no one's going to the beach.
No one should leave this building, really.
Hey. Rely on our intuition.
I still don't understand.
The idea that none of us could have killed Byakuya? It's not cruel. It's performing justice so we can find his killer.
Mm-hmm.
I won't believe.
Weird delivery.
You are right.
If we are able to survive.
This is the worst.
Yeah, we all agree. We all have to do this.
As long as we're all in agreement.
Let's stop talking to every person three times, all agreeing that we have to do this, and do this.
Is this feeling brewing inside me? Hope?
Right after this murder happened? Hopeful? Right after!
Investigation.
Man, that was a sound effect.
But...
What? No, I want to...
The Monokuma file!
There's like an autopsy?
Oh, what the hell is a Monokuma file?
Explaining all the rules this time really breaks my bones.
Does he have bones?
Not like he has bones in the first place.
Don't make me say
such lame jokes.
The file contains precise and detailed information regarding the dead body.
How precise?
I've brought it to you so you guys can smoothly proceed.
Do we even need an autopsy if he's got precise information?
Let's check out what that precise information is.
Want to be known as the Mother Teresa of the mascot world. Yeah, you're well on your way, Monokuma.
She's back. She's back to
Monomi, the meaningless mascot.
You stupid brother!
That's a genre?
Your turn is already taken up. They're finally gone.
Thank God. Okay, even I feel like that. When even the writers are complaining about the writing of the game.
Oh, it's like a
tablet. Oh. We've got this handy iPad on the island now. Maybe we can get some Wi-Fi and tell people we're here.
The victim's body was discovered in the dining hall of the old building near the hotel.
Mirai.
11:30.
Okay, 11:30.
The victim was repeatedly stabbed over ten times.
Yeah, that wasn't a fall. He did not fall on his knife. Through the throat and abdominal region, resulting in death.
Oh, geez, it shows the little, stab spots on that picture down there.
Oh, man. So, no poison. So, okay, Terror didn't poison, which is good.
Well, that's good to know.
Yeah, he didn't poison the food, so we're not all going to be dead in the long run.
Yeah, he had a whole thing.
Now we're never going to get to know about his skeptical nature.
I wonder if we'll, discover it through clues on the island or something.
But how would we find those? Because it's not like he's from the island. Despite being the island's dad. The dad of the island. What did he mean?
There is a traitor.
But why would he be the traitor if...
Well, he was working so hard to protect
all of us. To protect everyone, yeah, that doesn't make any sense. He wouldn't just be the traitor.
Yeah.
Pretending to be your ally and tricking you guys.
I mean, he did take all the weapons.
Yeah? Yeah, I don't think he was the traitor.
Whoa.
Truth bullet!
Anyway, we need to carefully examine everything.
I agree.
We're gonna survive this. We need to do it.
I have to prepare myself for the worst. There we go. Alright, so it's the beginning of-
Should we talk to people?
Yeah, and we should- Oh, the Duralumin case is open.
Oh yeah, the one that he was keeping in
here.
The
one that he had with him. What's in there? It's got a taser.
And a key! Ooh. Oh wait, that's the key to open the other case.
Oh yeah. Hard plastic case. So that was the case for the night vision goggles.
Mm.
Looks like it's the general shape. Small key to the other case. So no one was able to open the other case.
Right. Unless they like forced it open.
And then put the other key back. Yeah.
Aren't related to Byakuya's murder. It would be too obvious if they were.
Yeah, absolutely. Why did he have the case in the first place?
Because he was...
He was being extra precautious.
He wanted to be the one with the upper hand.
He's... Hajime's saying that's way too overboard. Everything Byakuya did was overboard.
He was just an overboard person. In his personality.
Yeah, exactly. Obtain truth bullet. I don't know what those truth bullets are for, but I like that we have them.
Oh, he's looking for his earring.
Oh.
Impossible!
Not a mirror earring.
Hellhound earring.
Fine.
Probably just an earring.
Long ago, in a faraway land, a beast known as the Hellhound was feared by all, even by he who summoned it.
I bought it at a flea market for $5.
Well, this is certainly random. The Hellhound tore its way through the innumerable battlefields, its fangs glistening with blood. And his drenched blood-red fur would dry in the howling winds. Of loneliness.
I bought it at a Hot Topic.
And when I finally tamed that diabolic beast, I received an earring to commemorate that event from where?
Hot Topic.
The Hellhound earring. So that I may never forget the night I battled that fearsome Pomeranian, I wear that earring at all times.
So he got like chased home from school one day? By like a loose Pomeranian.
And then he just found an earring on the ground.
And he was like, this is the symbol of my power.
I won't let you.
I won't let you investigate.
My earring.
The carpet didn't cover the whole floor. Okay, gaps between the floorboards again.
Okay, that's been brought up 3 times. Something's down. Or something's up. Nothing's down. Everything's up.
He pressed his head against the gaps in the floor.
I'm just imagining him just slamming his head down.
And peered beneath the floorboards.
Mystery solved. Now let's move on to the real one.
I see.
God exists
for
a reason. Finally.
Let me ask.
Good question. Yeah, how do we get down there?
Were I to use a tool, it would probably not reach either. Then maybe you should just give up.
Hajime is just like, it seems difficult.
Great Let's... attitude to start an investigation with.
For like the murder of your friend.
You!
I'm not sure whether or not to believe any part of what he says.
He's just, that's just categorically untrue. The world... I think maybe he's got some sort of, like, not, he's got some, like, delusions of grandeur.
Yeah.
You flinch, you will die!
Still not survive the winter? Oh, he's a Stark. Winter is coming.
Why am I being scolded? I didn't do anything!
I just found your earring, dude! I'm sorry! You could probably use one of the skewers to, like, pick it up from the length of that.
Mm.
Yeah.
They're locked inside the other case, I think. He wants the earring back by any means necessary. His determination is truly inspiring.
Be nice if he actually helped.
Cracks in the floorboard.
Gaps in the floorboard. Thigh gaps on the floorboard. That was a... She's having a rough time with this.
Well, I mean, one person did just die. I would feel the same way.
Why?
What if you just felt nothing? Yeah, it has been determined. He did die, for sure. You know, no one actually checked the body to see if he was breathing or could have been helped.
I guess that's true.
He could have been alive, like, when we, you know, oh boy. We, like, spent all that time going outside. I guess he probably would have, like, made a sound or something if he was still alive.
If he died, why didn't he scream? I feel like that would be...
Because he got stabbed, like, 10 times, you'd think he would scream, for sure.
Or, like, let out any sort of noise at all.
Yeah. Maybe we would hear it happening.
This is the worst.
This is the worst thing that could have happened.
Jeez.
Everyone could have died.
I guess that's true. One mass poisoning.
Yeah. It can always get worse.
Got it?
Yeah, she's got some...
She got some boy feelings that she needs to think about. A clue?
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Just... Well, it was a little bit well before the blackout, but yeah.
I wonder how many pictures she took. Snap. Oh, snap.
She took like 2. Digital camera, so I can show you right now. Oh, yeah.
That was essentially what we originally saw.
Well, Nagito is closest to the table, other than us.
Hmm.
I don't know.
Byakuya is farthest from the table.
Yeah.
Oh, whoa.
He's in like the opposite corner.
Look at Mikan. She looks like...
She looks shifty.
She looks very shifty.
Like, yeah. I mean, to be fair, so does Gundam. But Gundam
but
just looks like
shifty.
He's striking like an anime pose.
Yeah.
Like, how much Naruto do you think Gundam's watched? All of it, right?
All of it.
100% of the Naruto.
Byakuya was...
In a totally different place.
Like,
than,
opposite
yeah.
side of the room.
Yeah, farthest away.
So he had to, like... He had to, like, run to the other side of
yeah,
the room.
Yeah, seriously. Approximate everyone's standing position? Oh, that'd be helpful. Make, like, a floor plan.
Leave it to me. You better do your best.
It's cool that everyone has their own, like,
thing that they can do that...
Like, their own talent provides assistance in the investigation.
Except for Gundam.
Yeah.
His hamster's not really helping out this time.
Hey.
Run by him.
Byakuya was in the dining hall. If his dead body was discovered after the blackout... Well, yeah.
Yes.
He definitely didn't die when the lights came back on.
Yeah, no one murdered him when we all went to go look for him.
No one murdered him when we were all standing around watching each other.
He definitely didn't die when we heard him shout, ow. That definitely didn't happen.
What?
Hajime's just thinking about this for the first time. Well, the body needs to be found.
Yeah, I mean...
You don't want it to be hidden forever, otherwise you can't go through the trial and get out. Somebody might have heard something?
About her?
Her? The legendary hear master? Didn't Ibuki say that she had really good hearing?
Yes.
That makes sense, she's a musician, perfect pitch and all that. Yes, you are.
What did those little...
See, that happened to Terror say? Terror before, too. I don't know what they said. Rough. Well, okay, it's just gonna show us again. Well, come on.
Did you see that text said spread eagle?
What?
The text? It said, like, spread eagle.
Really?
You can click through this.
Listen. It was for the invest... I was investigating. Yeah, that's not... Listen, let's all forget that happened.
Oh, doing me straight with me, John. I'm not gonna forget this.
I will remember this for the rest of my life. Okay, well, I guess we should just go look at it?
Yeah.
Byaki was... the top of the... okay.
Because the top of the table takes precedent right
it's
now.
It's so interesting.
This...
it's got...
oh, I found it. A clue. This...
a desk lamp. It would have been useless during the blackout.
When all the power went out.
Because that's how electricity works. I'm such a good detective.
I thought he was going to say, other than that, there's nothing suspicious about the scene at all.
And nothing about this table is weird. I gotta do it. Just
I let out a shout as if to encourage myself. That would, like...
that'd be so concerning when just, like, anyone else is in that room.
And also everyone's, like, just nervous.
Yeah. Unexplainable smell. I actually think it's very explainable. It's 100% explainable, even. Slowly shifted my gaze towards Byakuya's glistening body. If you just, like, add one or two words into each of these sentences, it becomes an erotic novel.
You know how when you eat a fortune cookie and everyone says that you have to add in bed to the end?
Mm-hmm.
I slowly shifted my gaze toward Byakuya's body in bed.
Byakuya Tagami, the ultimate affluent prodigy. He was the kind of guy who said a lot of hurtful things in bed. But he tried his best to lead everyone. Why? Why did he have to end up like this? The only thing I can do right now, for Byakuya's sake's sake. I read that wrong. Thought they were talking about booze for a second. To uncover the truth!
Beneath the table, something stuck to the back of the table.
Duct tape?
Duct what? Tape.
It's glow in the dark.
Paint applied to the non-sticky side.
Seems to glow. Glowing paint.
To see it in the dark.
That wasn't a truth bullet. We got Mikan's pose. But the tape under the table where the murder happened...
with glow-in-the-dark tape on
it. It's not a clue. Hajime's just like, nothing suspicious about this.
This desk lamp, though? Definitely
very suspicious. Let me write down about the cord and how it was useless during the blackout.
He has a notepad. Desk lamp. Embarrassing pose.
Very suspicious.
Well, I've got all the clues I need.
He's got, like... red strings, like, trying to figure out the situation, but it's
on, like,
just those two things.
A bloody knife.
Is this the weapon that killed Byakuya?
This bloody knife?
I mean, if he was stabbed 10 times...
could this be the murder weapon? The knife with all the blood on it?
How did the killer bring the knife into the dining hall?
Byakuya thoroughly patted down.
Yeah.
There was the knives, but we didn't know that no one.
But
could
we
get
took
into the
case. Knives from the kitchen. And so unless it was like already in there before he did the pat down.
It's possible they hit.
They
it.
Hit
well,
it.
Of course, well, they had to hide it.
It was taped under the table. It has the same paint on it. Some kind of paint, the kind that we saw earlier.
Could this be glowing paint?
Now we get the get the glowing paint.
Okay, glowing. Wait. Can you click on the blood stain right there?
Where? Blood stain.
Yeah.
Formed a huge pool. Oh. A lot of blood.
No drag marks, which means that he was just killed under there.
Fun!
And now we discover his, or investigate his actual body.
I can just look at beneath the table.
That's just the paint.
Oh, it's just the paint again. Still not gonna give that a clue for us. Night vision goggles.
Clearly night vision goggles.
Very obviously night vision goggles. Hajime, you perhaps. Stupid idiot. Seen them at the supermarket. And in self-defense kits.
To kill Byakuya.
It's a weird self-defense kit that comes with night vision goggles. Like, you don't get mugged at night and are like, man, if I only had night vision goggles, everything would have been fine.
Can you,
investigate his body.
Poor guy.
middle of attempting something.
Ooh, with the knife?
He was repeatedly stabbed through the throat. Was he stabbed through the floorboards?
Repeatedly stabbed.
Because he died there. Pretty sure we've investigated. He is working pretty hard.
I feel like I'm working pretty hard.
I feel like I'm pretty
His
good at this.
His clipboard just has lamp and pose.
I guess we should take a look at the table and the dishes.
There are a lot of fancy foods here.
Nobody really ate that much. Well, one person definitely
did.
Ate a whole bunch.
But there's still so much food left.
There's a lot. There's probably too much food. Such a huge table. Seems fine.
There's still,
What if we...
Oh, iron plate. We already, like, talked about this, though.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I mean, there's the remote control AC thing.
Remote-controlled air conditioner.
Air conditioner? Could it be?
How can you tell it's remote-controlled? Beep, beep. Oh, that's right before.
Was it the beep-beep of the air conditioner? Our air conditioner doesn't beep-beep. I don't know if that's generally a noise that they make. Timer set to... That was the murder time.
Mm-hmm.
My flashes of inspiration aren't as bad as I thought. That's a weird...
I'm doing a pretty good job.
Hey, I'm figuring this murder stuff out.
Now then, where else should I investigate?
Hajime. Hey.
Sure. Talk to you out of caution. That's true.
Everyone would be on edge. Because we're friends. Wait a minute.
Feel like you have a scent similar to mine. Hey, Hajime, I smelled you, and I think that we have, like, a smell bond.
Thanks. Hajime's like, fine, if we're going together, let's get it over with.
Fine. Special feelings.
I don't think what he said about us having similar scents I agree with.
I'm more of like an amber, and he's more of like a beach rose.
Now then.
We should search the inside of this old building. We should consider this whole building. Well, yeah, we have to search all the rooms.
Yeah.
Alright.
I think this is probably... Yeah, oh wow, our running time is about an hour and a half.
Alright, yeah,
we should probably call it here. Alright, well, join us next time, which will actually be in the past of when we recorded this.
So where can they find us?
They can find us, at panic_hearts on Twitter. Or just like, subscribe, and comment on our YouTube stuff. It's a really good way to let us know that you guys like what we're doing.
And also our Facebook group.
Yeah, and also our Facebook group, which is facebook.com/panichearts, I believe, plural.
You can just find it as Panic Heart if you just type it in.
Can you?
I think so.
Oh, that's handy. Yeah, so join us next time.
And we for will continue the... this investigation.
Yeah, we'll figure out what went down in Island Town.
Bye!
To our sweet, beautiful... Island Daddy, R.I.P.
Next time
on Panic Heart Plays.
He seems suspicious.
Yeah.
He seems suspicious.
Who I think it is Terror Terror, the chef. Listen, everyone's a suspect.
He's the traitor?
Yeah. There's no real lead. Oh, man. I hope we have all the clues.